Hey y'all, Irix Guy here back again. Now what I want to demonstrate within this video, and you've probably already seen my ground station demonstration video right when ground station came out and I was using my iPhone 5. What I'm using today is the iPod Touch. So this is actually not a phone, but it behaves pretty much just like an iPhone. And this is the current model iPod Touch. And you can find a link within this video's description where you can order it online. It's a great way to control your craft without having to have a phone. So what we're going to do now, we got a baseball field, and I hope you can see this in the sunlight, but I'm going to set various waypoints, and you can check out the other video where I actually fly, and you'll be able to see that in the flight. So I set these waypoints here, and when you double tap, you can set the height. We're going to do about 300 feet. So we're going to go to home plate. Naturally, we're going to go to first base. Keep it right around 300 feet. Then we're going to go to second base. That's the cool thing about this. You can specify the height as you go. Then we're going to go to third base. Actually, I didn't position that quite correctly, but close enough. And then we're going to, after that, that'll be it. We're not even going to go home. So we're going to go home plate, first, second, and third. Now the one thing I wanted to mention about this, if you were wondering, well, the iPod Touch, obviously it doesn't have a cell phone built in, so it's not part of a cellular network. So how is it going to, how does it know where you are? Well, actually, once it connects with your Phantom, it'll see your Phantom on a map. You just got to be sure that when you're on a Wi-Fi network, to download the map of the area where you'll be flying, so you'll have it on here. That's one thing you can do with the iPhone that you can't with the iPod Touch. Obviously, with iPhone, you could using the cellular network update the map while you're out in the field if you had cell service. So we plotted our course. We're going to hit done, and it recaps. It says waypoint 1, 308 feet. Waypoint 2, 301 feet. Waypoint 3, 301. Waypoint 4, 298, and then home, 298. So we're going to go ahead and hit go, and what we should see here, we should see this Phantom take off. And it's going to fly itself to those waypoints. So you can see now the Phantom is flying itself. Now I'm going to keep my eye on it. I'm turning around, so I've got a visual. Actually, I'm going to turn the camera around so we can see here. So there's the baseball field over there. And it is flying itself right now, and I'm watching it on the screen. So this is pretty neat. Let me get this lined up better. So what we're seeing now, we're seeing the course, and I don't know how well you can see it in the sunlight. I'll know better when I get back and edit this video. But it's hit waypoint 1, so now it's going to first base, which is waypoint 2. And as this ground station app's running, you can see that it's, once it completes a certain, what it calls a mission, from waypoint to waypoint, it calls it a mission, it'll darken that waypoint. So now it's done waypoints 1 and 2. It's going to second base, which is waypoint 3. And now it's going to third base, which is waypoint 4. After that, it'll return home. And like I said, this is completely autonomous. I'm not controlling this. If I needed to regain manual control, I could do this. I could toggle this switch. Likewise, there's a pause icon within the DJI Vision app itself. So you could pause the flight path, the flight plan rather. And also, you could abort by hitting return home at any point. So it's got a lot of fail safes. Obviously, you want to be sure when you're doing this that you maintain visual line of sight with the craft. I mean, even though this technology is rock solid, you don't want to risk it. So now it's returned home. It says mission complete, so it's not going to land itself unless I do hit home. So now it's back home. It's completed the mission. So now I can say go home, and it's actually going to land where it took off at. On my case, and it sure is. It's coming right down on us right now. I'm not gonna let it land itself on the case because that's a pretty intense landing, but I'm gonna show you what this will. I see I can regain manual control toggling the S1 switch. And that's what I'm going to do, because I don't want it to land itself on the case. So now I've regained manual control. But that just illustrates, if you were on a flat surface and not something as small as that case, you could use the return home and let it land itself if you wanted to. So see, now I can land it on the case. But I don't want to land it right now. I want to fly it a little bit more. So let's take it back up and do some manual flying. But I hope you enjoyed this demonstration of the ground station. Because a lot of people say, oh, you don't get ground station with the Phantom 2 Vision Plus. And actually you do, it's built into the app. But you've got to make sure you update your firmware on your Phantom 2 Vision Plus, you update your app, and you have a compatible device. And like I said, in my case, what I'm flying with is the iPod Touch, which I like a lot because it doesn't have a phone built in. Especially if you do a lot of international travel like I do, you don't want to be in a position to where you bring your phone out and you're risking incurring international roaming charges. That's no fun. So just one of those things to think about when you're looking for the best device for flying your Phantom. And like I said, I personally think the iPod Touch is great. I like just the display on it, the Retina display. It's really good to see, even when it's kind of cloudy or whatnot. Just a really cool feature. And again, I've got a link within this video's description. You can find the Phantom 2 Vision Plus, the iPod Touch that I use. Also an Android tablet, a 7-inch Android tablet that I use. You can find it all there within this video's description. Just a really great, a lot of people refer to this as a tool. Some people will call it a toy. But there's no doubting, regardless of what your intended purpose of purchasing the drone is, it's very advanced technology. It's actually amazing what all it can do. I'm gonna fly by right here really low. Watch this. And obviously, like I said, I've got manual control. I've had manual control since I brought it back over where we are. But see, you can see this right here. Watch how slow I can go with it. I mean, you can literally just creep. Or you can go about, I've gotten this thing up to about 42, 45 miles per hour. It's really, really cool to bring it back towards the street. I'm going to bring it by at a high rate of speed. It'll go pretty fast. So that's it, that's ground station, and just flight in general with the Phantom 2 Vision Plus and an iPod Touch. So really cool way to fly your Phantom 2 Vision Plus. So thanks for watching, be sure to subscribe, youtube.com /iRixGuy and enjoy all my DJI Phantom 2 Vision Plus videos, as well as find a link to all this equipment that I use, the case, the Phantom, the iPod Touch, the tablet when I'm flying with the 7-inch Android tablet. So thanks for watching, and y'all have a good day.